Sunday's Dolphins-Patriots tilt features a pair of the league's best cornerbacks and most prominent ball hawks. Last season, Stephon Gilmore won NFL Defensive Player of the Year, breaking a 10-year drought for defensive backs in that honor. Gilmore racked up 6 interceptions, 20 passes defensed, and allowed opposing quarterbacks to complete just 49.0% of their passes when targeting him in coverage. With 3 games to play, Howard is allowing a completion rate of 49.3% with 9 interceptions and 17 passes defensed, on pace for 21. It had been a decade since Troy Polamalu won DPOY in 2010, but he did something Dolphins cornerback Xavien Howard has a shot of replicating in 2020, making it back-to-back Defensive Player of the Year wins for defensive backs. Charles Woodson won the award in 2009 with a remarkable 13 takeaways produced, 9 interceptions, 4 forced fumbles. Howard could realistically mark, but he's already topped Gilmore's 2019 takeaway production and Polamalu's in 2010, 7 interceptions, 1 forced fumble. With 3 games left, Howard needs 1 interception to tie the single-season franchise record, a mark set in 1967 by cornerback Dick Westmoreland. And he's doing it in an era where double-digit interception seasons simply don't happen anymore. The last time a player intercepted 10 or more passes was 2007, Antonio Cromartie of the Chargers. Even if Howard doesn't intercept another pass, his 9 interceptions are the most in the NFL since 2012, when Chicago's Tim Jennings picked off a career-high 9 passes. Miami Dolphins head coach Brian Flores has coached both Howard and Gilmore. They are both very competitive, obviously very talented, both have very good ball skills, both excellent players, Flores said. They are both team-first guys. They'll be the first to tell you that it's not their personal situation but more about the team. Both excellent players. Like Howard, Dolphins defensive end Emmanuel Ogbah is near the top of the leaderboard in some of the most prominent defensive statistics. His 8 sacks are tied for 10th in the league, 4th among defensive ends, and his 20 quarterback hits are 8th, 5th among edge defenders. According to Pro Football Focus, his 56 quarterback pressures are 3rd among all edge defenders. Ogbah's 3 forced fumbles are tied for 7th, with 2 of the fumbles producing defensive touchdowns for Miami. No other player has multiple forced fumbles returned for touchdowns in the NFL this season. It's not just Ogbah's tangible sack and pressure production that is making an impact. One of Patrick Mahomes' 3 interceptions Sunday came after Ogbah's pressure forced the former MVP to throw off balance as he was getting hit by big number 91. Linebacker Jerome Baker broke an NFL record with a 30-yard sack, biggest loss on a sack without a fumble, but he didn't alone. Ogbah's immediate pass rush win forced Mahomes to spin out of the initial trouble and into Baker's crosshairs. One metric that scores the impact of the sacks and pressures of all defenders is Brandon Thorne's The Scouting Academy and EstablishTheRun.com, True Sack Rate, a film project to quantify sack production. The project evaluates every sack on the basis of how it occurred. More points are awarded for splitting a double team than chasing down a quarterback who has escaped previous pressure from another rusher. Ogbah ranks 5th among all edge defenders in this category with a true sack rate of 7.0. He trails only TJ Watt, Joe Bosa, Za'Darius Smith and Myles Garrett. Thorne scored 3 of Ogbah's sacks as high quality, which also ranks 5th in that category. Sanders scores Ogbah's big plays have produced points on the scoreboard for Miami this season, but nobody has lit up the scoreboard more than kicker Jason Sanders. In fact, only one player in the league than Sanders. His 120 points are just 4 off the pace of the league leader, Atlanta kicker Younghoe Koo. Sanders got there by topping a franchise record that stood for more than 2 decades. Alindo Mayer knocked down 19 consecutive field goals in 1999. Sanders put 22 straight field goals through the uprights between 2019-2020. Mayer joined the Fish Tank podcast this week to talk late 90s, early 2000s Dolphins football on the Miami Dolphins podcast network. Sanders is first in the AFC in field goals made, 30. His 93.7 successful field goal percentage is also tops in the conference among kickers with at least 20 attempts.